Hi, I'm Bryce. President Obama's administration has, as far as I can tell, now put in place the strongest steps ever to fight climate change, with the EPA's new rule capping carbon dioxide emissions from coal-fired power plants. This is going to be basically a guarantee that the biggest source of climate change causing greenhouse gas emissions being pumped into the environment from the world's dominant economy will continue to fall over the next 15 years. Yes, continue to fall. Because what's not being widely covered by the media is that even without this rule, we're already pretty much on pace to achieve this target. Emissions from coal have come down roughly 13% from the 2005 high mark in just 9 of the 25 years that'll pass between 2005 and 2030. But what I do find newsworthy about the EPA's new rule is the message it sends, because it pretty much is the final nail in coal's coffin. That's why you're seeing temper tantrums from coal industry-funded politicians and the coal lobby, those sellouts who have been fighting the inevitable progress of our energy sector for decades. This is Senator Obama discussing the future prospects of the coal industry.
Overall policy. I mean, what I've said is that we would put a cap and trade system in place that is as aggressive, if not more aggressive, than anybody else's out there. I was the first to call for 100% auction on the cap and trade system, which means that every unit of carbon or greenhouse gases was emitted would be charged to the polluter. That will create a market in which whatever technologies are out there that are being presented, whatever power plants that are being built, that they would have to meet the rigors of that market and the ratcheted down caps that are placed, imposed every year. So if somebody wants to build a coal power plant, they can. It's just that it will bankrupt them because they're going to be charged a huge sum for all that greenhouse gas that's being emitted.
Now, because coal industry backed mainly Republican politicians in Congress have refused to institute a cap and trade system, Obama and the EPA have used their power to act in America's best interest. With such a clear signal from the US government that coal is no longer acceptable, the shift to the alternative energy sources and sector will accelerate even faster. Coal's share of the market is already being replaced by natural gas, which is cheaper and produces about half as much CO2 as coal. Clean energy sources like solar and wind have also boomed under President Obama and bitten into coal's share of the market. The other important part of the story is the strong message it sends to the rest of the world that the United States is finally ready to lead on climate change. This is crucial because world leaders will work to establish a framework that sets binding international limits on greenhouse gas emissions at a climate conference next year in Paris. The major obstacle to achieving this kind of agreement has always been that the world's leading economy and second biggest energy producer, us, haven't been willing to impose strong limits on ourselves, which makes it impossible to force emerging economic powerhouses like China and India to do the same. But now, just after the US announced the new rules, the next day in fact, China signaled that it may be close to issuing its own limits. This is huge. China is now emitting nearly twice as much CO2 as the US because its booming middle class is very addicted, understandably, to cheap electricity generated by coal power plants. They want what we have: washers and dryers and microwaves and dishwashers and TVs and computers and lights all over their houses. And India is on the same path. They're planning more than 450 new coal plants, and that's more than the 360 or so planned in China. So reining in the emissions of these two emerging giants is the key to keeping climate change at a manageable level. And it seems that the United States just added a lot of argumentative credibility to this effort. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this episode of The Conversation, hit that like button and share it with your friends to start a discussion of your own. And if you disagreed with anything I said, let me know in a comment below.